Very happy to be here today. I do want to acknowledge that we are on the unceded territory that's related to the Musqueam and Squamish First Nations. Before I get started, I'm David Black, I'm the president. Before I get started, I just wanted to get the table officers, the other table officers in the room, to stand up and introduce themselves. We've got Annette Toth from ICBC, Christy Cicerenko. Board members just to stand up very briefly as well. So folks can see who we are. Lisa Cronenberg in the back. Ramesh, okay, sorry. Sorry, Ramesh. I'll get that sooner or later. Brian Finstead from ICBC. Tim Wangel. James Doodle from Board of Customer Care. Brian Martins from ICBC. Gloria Kirk from Coastal Communities Credit Union. And there's many executive counselors in the room as well, so could executive counselor just stand up and give everyone a wave? I won't introduce all of you. Improve your skills so that we can serve our members better. I also would like MoveUP staff to stand up for a moment and wave for everyone as well. Giving their weekends up to help educate all of you and all of us. They are very, very dedicated to our union. We are the union we are because of those people, and I want to thank them for giving up their weekends to be with us today. How many of you are first-time job stewards here? Stepping forward and for taking this training and any other training that you may have taken or will take in the future. The role of the steward is the most important role in our union. It's been a long time since I was on the work floor and I was a steward, but I remember the work that it went in there, and that when the members think of the union, they think of you. They don't think of me, they don't think of the staff reps, they don't think of any of the other elected people. They think of the person that they know in their workplace who they count on every day to stand up for them, to defend the collective agreement, to make sure that they're treated fairly. So the role that you have is incredibly important for our union. We spend a lot of money on this job steward seminar. Winnie and you can do a lot of work, and that's to support you in that role, because that is the most important role in our union. Those of you that have done it for a while will know that quite often you don't get thanks for the work that you've done on behalf of the members. Members will come to you, usually it's when there's something wrong, they've gotten themselves into trouble, they haven't been treated fairly, they haven't been paid fairly, something like that. That quite often they're upset, quite often they're emotional, and while they count on you, and while they appreciate the work that you do, sometimes they don't think to say thank you for the work that you've done on their behalf. What is odd about my position is that I'll go and visit people in the workplace, people that I've never met before, and they'll thank me for what the union did for them 15 years ago, or 5 years ago, or 2 months ago. I didn't name anything for them personally. What they are thanking me for is the work that you guys have done and will do for them. So they are appreciative, even if they don't seem to be in the moment. Doing the work of a job steward is difficult. It's on top of your regular job. Members don't always know that or respect that. When they're in trouble, they want to talk to you on your coffee breaks, on your lunch breaks, before work, after work. They don't realize that their problem is taking up your own free time. But I want to thank you, and the rest of the board wants to thank you for all the work that you're doing on behalf of our members. We wouldn't be the union that we are without all of the work that you guys do and continue to do. So thank you very much. Stepping forward to get this training and other training that you may have got. You are donating your own time, as are many of the people in this room, to get that training to better serve our members. So thank you very much for coming down here, giving up your Friday night, giving up your Saturday, giving up part of your Sunday. It really does make a difference. Hopefully, one of the things that we can do is build some camaraderie here. Not just learn from your instructors, but learn from other people in your classes, maybe people that in your workplace or in other classes, and build some relationships that will cement that relationship with each other and with the union. So I want to talk a little bit about some of the social events. We are here to learn first and foremost, but we're also here to have a good time and to get to know each other and to build some networks. But when you read out that we do have an harassment policy, and I want to make sure that people are aware that we're having a good time, but that's not ever at someone else's expense. So please make sure that your behavior is always respectful, that the event on Saturday, there will be alcohol, but we want to make sure that you're respecting everyone's boundaries, because the last thing we want is for someone's quote good experience to infringe on someone else's learning experience. So we take those issues very, very seriously. Gwynny talked about Tampon Tuesday coming up in a couple of weeks. And last year for Tampon Tuesday, I was going to the Women's March in Vancouver with my 11-year-old daughter. And I said, oh, they've got a box out for tampons and for feminine protection products. She goes, oh, that's a really good idea. She's prepubescent, I guess I need to say that, to give the proper context. I said, well, we should stop and get some and take them down there. And so she said, oh, well, is that what we're doing? I said, yeah, we'll do that. So we went into a convenience store, and we went in, and I said, which one should she get? I don't know which one she get. So we just bought a big box of things. And as we were leaving the store, she said, Dad, it's a good thing that I was with you. So it was a lot of fun doing that, but it does make a very big difference. As Winnie said, it is a basic hygiene product. It's no different than other supplies that you find in a public bathroom, and my view, it should be free for everyone, not just for these people, but for people that are seeing violence and looking after themselves or their families. It's a very real hardship, and this goes a long ways to making a difference for them to get back on their feet. Another issue I just wanted to talk about is an initiative that was led by the CLC, started last year, on domestic violence in the workplace. And what we are tabling in all of our collective agreements, that you may know this if you've been in your recent round of collective bargaining, is that paid leave for members that are affected by domestic violence. It's not always men on women violence, but it almost always is men on women violence. Something that we take very seriously. I'm actually somewhat pleased at how receptive employers are to this. It's less of a fight with them in many cases than I had anticipated, but it's important that we work for all of that language in all of our collective agreements, so we're going to continue doing that. I want to thank Adrian as a representative of the CLC for the great work that they've done. We had sessions at our midterm conference at the national level a couple weeks ago on that as well, so we're going to continue working. I want to stop and one more time and thank all of the facilitators for giving up their weekend. And when he introduced them all to you, you are very, very lucky with the amount of experience that these people have, the breadth of experience, not just in the labor movement, but in the community as well. You're in for a real treat with your education this weekend. And I know how many people are here for not their first time, their second, third, or fourth time. Exactly. So I think that speaks to the testimony to the type of education that Winnie and the committee are able to pull together, that people come back time and time again because the quality of education that we get through our volunteer facilitators is really fantastic. I can't finish without talking about Winnie and her 13 years of doing these job sort seminars. Andy Ross is over there. He was the one who asked her to take on this role, but she's been continuing on that role all through the time that I've been president. These job steward seminars are extremely popular, as you can see from this room, and that is a testimony to the amount of work and the skill that Winnie and the other folks bring to putting these on. So she is going to be deeply, deeply missed when we start planning for the next one in 2019, but I do want to thank her for doing all this fantastic work on behalf of all of us, bringing you back year after year after year, so thank you very much. Finally, I want to thank you guys again for giving up your weekend. for giving up the time that you already have to become job stewards and the time, quite frankly, that you will continue to be giving up your own personal time, your break time, your lunch times, and so on to serve our members. It really is appreciated by me. It's appreciated by all of our members, so thank you very much. The next thing that we'll be doing is introducing our guest speaker. Diego Cardona is joining us here today. I first met Diego when I was on the board of the Vancouver Foundation, and one of the staff there, Mark Gifford, had been working very closely with Diego on something called Fresh Voices. It's in his bio. It seems like a long time ago now, Diego, but he's still very much a young man. He brings a unique perspective here. He's done many, many things in his years. He's won many, many awards that are outlined in the in the bio that you have in your kit. What it doesn't say here is that he was a candidate in the civic election last year for city council. And I want to thank Diego for stepping up in those difficult circumstances to bring a voice that, quite frankly, is not being heard enough in Vancouver. That is the voice of immigrant youth and speaking for those people. So thank you very much, Diego.